of fifth graders told to sing while picking cotton in a field.
I'm livid right now.
In the middle of Black History Month.
I'm African American and my ancestors pick cotton. Why would I want my son to pick cotton and think it's fun?
This cell phone video shot by a teacher was sent to parents.
Okay.
And brought this mom to tears.
I think it's making a mockery.
A mockery of what?
A mockery of slavery, a mockery of what our people went through.
Jessica Blanchard's 10-year-old son, Jamari, says he didn't understand what he was singing. Nor did teachers explain how cotton fields were harvested by African American slaves.
Did they talk about how slaves used to pick cotton?
No.
A permission slip sent to parents does mention picking cotton as part of a history lesson, not on slavery, but the Great Depression. For 15 years, Rock Hill fifth graders have been coming to the Carroll School, which was built in 1929 by and for African Americans. It now serves as a teaching center for African American history during the Great Depression and is run by Rock Hill Schools. The district calls this, quote, a unique learning opportunity that promotes understanding about our past and helps students make real life connections.
They thought it was funny.
Jamari says picking cotton was part of a game. He thought it was fun.
It was a contest. Whoever picked the least amount of cotton had to hold the big sack called Big Mama.
There is no race. The kids go out there and they pick, and this, the Big Mama concept is just a, you know, it's humor.
81-year-old Wally Cathcart is an instructor here at the Carroll School, where he was also a student in 1943. The son of sharecroppers, this former cotton farmer now shows kids what he and his parents had to do to survive.
We need innovation in the educational system, not just lecturing children, seeing them up in a classroom.
School officials say they correct children if they mention slavery, saying this is about the Great Depression. Cathcart calls the lesson living history.
What do you say to people who find this offensive and say that this trivializes slavery?
I certainly love to answer that question because I deal with this issue all the time. One of the problems when it comes to African-American people is that they fail to understand history in its proper context, and because of that, we're at a disadvantage today.
I asked why they skip over the history of slaves being forced to pick cotton. That's when district spokesman Michael Frost stopped the interview. As for Blanchard and her son, both support the Carroll School and its mission, but say this history lesson goes too far.
I think it's misguided, and maybe ignorance on their part.
In Rock Hill, South Carolina, Matt Grant, Fox 46, Charlotte.